the market thing as well. Like,
tell me a bit about that. Who, I heard they started the market, or they were involved at the beginning of the market.
Yeah.
Well, your dad was on the original bylaws from 84, right? As one of the directors.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's right. Yeah. And that was at the startup of the Memorial Center Market, and prior to that, we were at the old Market Plaza on Rink Street. I went with my dad there. There weren't that many vendors, but we used to go there. My dad was a market goer. My grandfather on my dad's side, he went to the market as well. And my mom, when she, before she was married, she went to the market with her parents as well. And at that time, my understanding is the market was underneath the town clock in downtown Peterborough. Growing up on a farm, like for me, we were poor, and I'm still poor. Like it's, but it is a good life. And like in those days, when I was a kid, you know, I do get a bit nostalgic when I look back on it. But in my mind, farm, like it was hard making a living on a farm then, but it's probably harder now. And back then, there was a very, most farmers that I knew were very diversified, you know. So my dad, he grew potatoes, he grew turnips, he grew oats, he grew barley, grew a whole whack of stuff. He had beef cattle, pigs, chickens, and most farmers were kind of like that. They were very diverse. The thing I like about farming is kind of the lack of control. You know, that's one thing that I think farmers in general share, is that you're in this circumstance and, you know, you kind of control what you can, but you realize at the outset that there are a lot of things that are beyond your control and a lot of things that are not going to pan out. You get very used to disappointments, but you just take that in stride. You know, in my experience, everybody kind of craves security and craves control over the various elements of their life. And in my opinion, that's not realistic, and at some point everybody comes to discover that. But on a farm, you learn that quite early. Like it's that's the nature of the profession. When I was growing up, the agribusiness was not the kind of phenomenon it is now. Like now, when you're driving through the countryside, you know, I would say, I don't know, like a high percentage of the farms that you drive past are operated by large, really large growers, like guys that, you know, have perhaps thousands of acres and, you know, equipment inventory that, you know, in the millions kind of thing. And they're usually very specialized, right? Like these are not people who are, you know, like growing various field crops and raising some livestock. Like they, I mean, it's, you know, on average, a lot of the farms around here are in corn and soybeans. That's what a lot of guys are growing. So I don't like that trend. And I personally have no desire to be a business person. Like I try to not not go bankrupt, you know, I have no desire in maximizing profits. I don't subscribe to that kind of thinking at all. I'm just, you know, in my ideal world, like you just, you know, you're growing things or you're producing things that people need, and you're providing them directly to those people that need them. Like that's kind of a sensible way to do it.